Well, are you ready to write off an entire generation? Aren't we stuck in an educational system that doesn't get what we need and what we want? We're listening to some awesome ideas today, but are those ideas too little, too late? I heard a student say last year, "Schools teach me what I need to know, not how to think." Is she right? As an employer, I'm a customer of this system, and like you, I'm stuck. And what makes it worse, I contribute to its dysfunction. You see, every day we sift through thousands of resumes to find the right talent so that my company can stay competitive and innovative. We go through criteria, we put in search keys, we look for experience, academic achievement. I hired two candidates, both of them from the same school, same degree, same grade point average. One turns out to be a wonderful employee. The other can't figure out the job and eventually leaves. Why is that? So I decide to increase the requirements. Instead of a bachelor's, I'm going to ask for a master's. And instead of 10 years experience, I'm going to ask for 15 years experience. I share my dilemma with universities and colleges all across the country. And the academic response is, let's design Calculus 7 and require all engineers to take that course. Wow. What we're doing here is we're creating academic inflation. Sir Ken Robinson talks about that in his TED Talk. Frankly, we're shooting in the dark, and we're not getting the results that we need. Do you realize that 90% of the jobs require math skills at a sixth grade level? Shouldn't I rethink how I qualify my talent? 2 years ago, we started an extraordinary project, a workforce pilot. The goal was simple. How do I place talent with no degree, no experience, successfully into jobs? How would I qualify such talent? After some in-depth research and experimentation, we decided to use cognitive skills assessments. Cognitive skills, in plain English, is the ability to figure things out. What we discovered is that individuals with no degrees score just as high as individuals with degrees. We also found that schools don't teach cognitive skills. Somehow we think it's innate. We learn this at home. We also know that the length of education just marginally improves your cognitive skills over time. As an employer, those cognitive skills assessments give me 5 times more accurate results. I can predict 5 times better whether an employee is going to perform in a job or not. It's not a new idea. After World War II, a lot of veterans were assessed with these methods and placed successfully into jobs and academic tracks. The process is really simple. First, you identify the job, you evaluate the job for the cognitive areas and the levels needed. Second, you assess the talent and you make the match. And third, which I think is the best news, is the fact that you can learn these skills and you can teach these skills to students and the workforce. This opens up a whole new set of possibilities for schools and employers alike. A recent case study, a company, a high-tech company, decided to improve their technical sales capabilities across the country. What they did, which is the normal track, is they placed their best engineers in technical sales support jobs across the country. Boy, what a disaster that was. These engineers didn't listen to the customers. They couldn't come up with ideas that met the customers' needs. And furthermore, the salespeople were tired of working with them. On the flip side, listening and observation skills are found to a very high level in child care workers across the country. So a gutsy move, the company hired childcare workers in major metro areas, paired them up with the engineers, taught them the technology, and let them go after it. And guess what? The results were fabulous. Their sales increased, and guess what? The salespeople were even happy working with these employees. So what does that lead me to? I believe we do not have to write off an entire generation. I believe that we need to incorporate cognitive skills, assessments, and development in schools and in the workforce alike, in universities as well. I would like to invite you this year to start a whole new and innovative talent marketplace that incorporates these kinds of ideas. The educational ideas that you're hearing about today, many of them, like project-based learning or inquiry-facilitated methods, are really about teaching our kids cognitive skills. I think the ideas are right, and we need to act now.